everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Bitmoji classroom on Canva.com. Canva is a graphic design platform that allows users to create graphics, presentations, posters, and other visual content. It provides thousands of templates, clip arts, and stock images. What's really cool is it provides pro features that are free for educators. If you're interested in learning how to sign up for their free education account, please check out my other tutorial video link below. I'm going to first show you how to create a Bitmoji classroom in presentation mode. At the end of this video, I will also show you how to turn your Bitmoji classroom into a GIF, a GIF, or a video. Once you're on the home page, you can either click the recommended presentation template or click the Create a Design button and type in presentation if you don't see the option. Now that we're in the design mode, you want to first insert a wall and floor background for your classroom. I didn't find any picture I wanted in the background tab, so I searched for the picture in the photos tab instead. After typing the words wall floor, I found this wooden wall and floor background I really liked. You can drag and adjust the size of the photo to your liking. Next, I'm putting the essential furniture like whiteboard, office desk, chair, and plants in my classroom. To do so, you want to find the clip arts in the elements tab. I'm planning to put the lesson objective on the whiteboard, so I'm going to make it as big as possible. There are so many clip arts to choose from, you can always try it out and delete it if you don't like it. Just click on the object and either right click, then delete, or click the trash can icon on the top right corner, or press the delete key on your keyboard. Don't worry if you accidentally delete the background by accident. You can always click the undo icon on top or press the Ctrl and Z keys. Now that we have some basic furniture, it's time to add your Bitmoji. You are going to need to use the Google Chrome browser and install the Bitmoji extension. If you've never used Bitmoji before, you can either sign up for an account using Snapchat or email on the Bitmoji app. After logging in your account in the Chrome extension, you'll want to search Post because it gives you a lot of choices of full body Bitmoji. You can drag and drop the Bitmoji, so you will need to copy and paste it. I'm picking this one because I want to sit on the chair and also hold things in my hands. To show students the math vibe, I'm going to hold a calculator. So, every math classroom has at least one or two math posters. I searched for math posters in the Elements tab, but I found out the clip arts don't really look like posters, so I've decided to use photo frames. The frame is the newest object added, so it covers the math shapes, but you can just right-click on the frame and send to back. If you want to make it easier to move around two elements, you can select both elements and click Group on the top right corner to group them together. So I just continue to create more math posters until the wall doesn't look empty. To make my classroom look more lively, I also decided to add some plants. I've always wanted to grow some plants in my actual classroom, but I've never got the time. Now I can grow as many plants as I want in my virtual classroom. The floor looks kind of empty, so I'm going to throw in a carpet. Finally, I'm going to add a class pad, because why not? If you want to put learning objective on the whiteboard, you can click the text tab, but now I just want to add some graphs for decoration. And here you go, my Bitmoji classroom is done. So this could be the cover page of your presentation, and you just need to add a new page after this to make lesson slides. You can also share the presentation link to students during remote teaching or just click present. If you want to download your Bitmoji classroom as an image, click the resize button on the top left corner and choose poster, or enter your desired dimensions. I'm choosing YouTube thumbnail because I want the right image size for my YouTube video. If you look at the top right corner, the option has changed from present to download. Click the down arrow button to choose the file type. Another cool thing to do is to make your Bitmoji image move in the classroom. To do that, you want to first click resize again and type in video. I'm planning to move my Bitmoji 3 times, so I will copy the same page 3 times. On each page, I'm adding myself in different poses. You can click the play button to preview your video. If you want to adjust the speed of each slide, click Animate, choose Simple, and change the timing. If you click the down arrow next to Download, you can choose to download the animation as a video or GIF. Thank you for watching my tutorial video. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to subscribe to my channel before you go. Until next time!